Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at the Prolin Windows Worm. Now I have taken a look at this before, but back then it was under the name Creative Windows Worm. This is due to various antivirus companies naming worms different things, and this time we're going by Kaspersky's naming rather than F-Secure's. So before we take a look at it, we got a few standard JPEG files we just have here. So just your standard JPEGs found by searching for JPEG files on the computer. So we'll go ahead and run the worm, which would arrive on your system through an email. So you can see, we've got a few emails sent, and your JPEGs are gone. So we look at what the worm sent. A great Shockwave Flash movie. Check out this new Flash movie that I downloaded just now. It's great. The worm is attached. Bye. Same thing sent to all your contacts, and it sent an additional email, presumably to the worm author, got yet another idiot. So the worm registers itself to run a startup, searches for all your drives, and gathers all zip files, JPEG files, and MP3 files, and moves them all into the root C drive, and renames them to the file name .jpeg change atleast now to Linux. So it also drops a text file. Hi, guess you have got the message. I have kept a list of files that I have infected under this. If you are smart enough, just reverse back the process. Could have done far better damage. I could have even completely wiped your hard disk. Remember, this is a warning, and get it sound and clear. The Penguin. It's kind of hard to sound like a badass when your online alias is The Penguin, but whatever. So it has here a list of all the files that it found and moved and renamed. But it is quite easy to restore them. As it says, if you know what you're doing, all you do is click on it, remove change at least now to Linux, and you're good to go. And so you can automate this process with a command prompt window. CD SQL. So we have all these change at least now to Linux stuff. Let's rename star.jpg star.jpg. So now when we refresh, all of our JPEGs should be back to normal, viewable, no longer change at least now to Linux, go away, window, and we can do the same thing for zip files. So as you can see, all the file names changed back, and your archives are now once again ready to go, and now the only pain in the ass part would be moving all of these files back to the directories they needed to be in. Which would be especially a pain in the ass if you had many programs installed or hundreds of thousands of files on the hard drive. But that's really about it for the worm. Send itself to your contacts, mocks you for not using Linux, and basically that's about it.